everybody, hope you're doing all right. So this is a foam roller session this morning. It is relatively hard work, but not too bad. So as always, just notice how you feel. If at any stage something doesn't feel great, then just stop. If you're on the roller, gently come off of the roller. If you've done plenty on the roller before, that's great. If you haven't done a lot and you're not used to being on it for a very long time, you might want to pause, have a little breather halfway through, and come off, and then reset yourself. We are going to do a little bit of work with the roller across underneath the middle of our back, and that will involve some extension over the roller. So the main thing when we do that, and I will remind you at the time, is that you just look after your neck. So if you always imagine you've got your soft peach between your chin and your chest, and you just need to keep that soft peach there without letting it roll away and without squashing it, that will help you just to keep your neck in a nice alignment and make sure it stays safe and comfortable. Okay, so we will get started. So, need your foam roller, probably want a little head cushion as well. It is much comfier when you've got a head cushion on your roller, just a bit easier to relax into that position. So, sit yourself right on the end of the roller, gently lie yourself down, grab your head cushion. And then just take a moment to let your body just relax into that roller. And then when you're ready, we'll bring feet together and step toes apart and bring your heels in line with your toes. So it is worth just making sure that your feet are equal distance from the midline of your roller. So that might mean that you have to just sit up and have a little check. And then lay yourself like that down again. Okay, so nice deep breath in, really fill your body with air, and then as you breathe out, just let your body sink around that roller. And obviously that roller should be right in the center of your back. So just take a bit of time, really notice where you can feel the pressure, whether it does feel absolutely central, whether there's a little bit more pressure one side than the other of your backbone, and just take a minute to process that information and notice how you feel there. So another couple of deep breaths, breathing in, filling the body with air, breathing out, just letting your body sink around the roller. And on the next out breath, we're just going to gently roll the pelvis towards us. And then on the in breath, just allow the pelvis to roll away. So just checking you're able to stay nice and relaxed. Shoulders are gently drawing away from the ears. Got that nice length through the back of the neck. Just checking through those things as you gently roll the pelvis towards you, roll away, and you'll feel that it's usually a little easier when you're on the roller for your pelvis to roll away from you because your feet are lower than your bottom. It's kind of pulling you into that anterior tilt already. A little bit trickier sometimes to get that roll towards. So in an ideal world, we'd like to be in a neutral position. So just settle that pelvis sort of midway between those two movements, or you may need to feel just a little flatter. So if you're not sure, make the diamond with your hands, thumbs in your belly button, fingers down towards your legs, and just check that your thumbs and fingers are completely level. Okay, so as I mentioned, it is really easy for your pelvis to roll away from you on your roller, which brings your back into an arch up and away from that roller, and we don't want that. So just be really mindful that you maintain neutral. Or if you struggle with that, you may need to think more about even just keeping the contact with the roller all the way along the middle of your back. So it just helps to keep you in a nice safe position through the back. So you just maybe will want to come a little bit flatter into the roller. The main thing is you are comfortable and can relax there. So if you're not, please let me know and we'll work out what's going on. Right, okay, enough chat. Let's have hands up towards the ceiling. Shoulder width apart, palms facing,
We're just going to start with some scapular isolation. So we're going to breathe in, float the hands up, and breathe out, and just let the shoulders sink down around the roller. So all the time, keeping the collarbones wide, breathing in to float the hands up, breathing out to just let those shoulders sink down, and just check that your elbows stay relatively straight, and those arms stay shoulder width apart. And the bonus of doing this on the roller compared to the mat is that you should be able to feel that sink down through the shoulders a little bit more than when they're slightly restricted by the floor. Okay, let's go for one more. And then let those shoulders sink down. So we're going to go through a little arm series. So we're going to turn our palms to face the knees. We're going to drop our elbows out so they come into line with our shoulders. And then we're going to keep those elbows in the same spot and just roll the arms backwards so the back of the hands come parallel to the floor. And then reach those hands towards the wall behind you. And then coming back so those elbows are in line with the shoulders. Rolling so the palms face the knees and then reaching up again. So if you have any shoulder problems, any rotator cuff problems, just take this really gently, really slowly, and if at any point it doesn't feel comfortable, then do not persevere. If you can find a comfortable range to work in, then that's great, but otherwise go back to doing those little scapular isolations, or you could just do some arm openings instead. So as long as that feels comfortable for you, should be finding a nice stretch through the front of the shoulders, maybe into the chest a little bit. And keeping the back of the rib cage heavy down into the roller. Keeping your neutral position through lower back and pelvis. So just dropping those elbows out, rolling to the back of the hands are parallel to the floor. Reaching for the wall behind you. Coming back so those elbows are in line with the shoulders, rolling and reaching up. We're just taking those shoulders through a nice range of movement. We're also just mobilising those muscles in between the shoulder blades with that roller underneath you. So just generally kind of opening up the front of the body. It's really nice to counteract sort of desk work, driving, all that kind of stuff. Okay, let's go for one more. And we're going to pause as we come back through with those elbows in line with the shoulders and the hands pointing up towards the ceiling. And then we're going to take one arm one way and the other arm the other. So we're taking the back of one hand towards the mat and then the palm of the other. And the tricky bit of this exercise is to keep your elbows in line with your shoulders. So we're just looking for rotation through the shoulder, nothing else. And yet, if this is not comfortable for you, then come away from it. Okay, one more each direction. And then pause with those palms just facing the knees. Reach up one last time. And let those arms come back to the mat. Okay, just have a little breather there, a little roll through the shoulders. We're going to take those hands back up towards the ceiling. Really check those collarbones are wide, shoulder blades are drawing down towards your back pockets, and we're going to go into some arm scissors. So we're just going to breathe out, reach one hand towards the wall behind you, one towards the floor, and then switching over. So all the time, staying nice and still on the roller. If you feel you're a little bit wobbly, just focus into your deeper tummy muscles, thinking about drawing little bony hip points towards each other as you breathe out, and just relaxing as you breathe in. So you kind of just reset on each out breath. Okay, one more each way. And then And pause with those hands up towards the ceiling again. And we're going to go into arm circles. So we're going to breathe out, travel the hands towards the wall behind you. Breathe in and draw them around a nice half circle. Palms facing each other as those hands travel backwards. Palms towards the ceiling as the arms come around in the half circle. Go one more in this direction. And then pause with those hands up towards the ceiling. We're going to go the other way, sticking the hands down towards the legs, opening the arms wide towards the wall behind you, and then coming up through the centre. And again, palms facing up as those arms go wide, and palms facing each other as the arms come up through the middle. Let's go for one more. And let those arms come down to the mat. So if you want a little bit more support from your arms, then you can take them a bit wider, have the palms flat on the floor, or if you want a bit less support, a little bit closer to you, still so they can relax, palms facing up. Okay, so we're going to start with our level one hip twist. Check your neutral position again, check you've got that length through the back of the neck. And then when you're ready, nice breath out, draw a little bony hip points towards each other and opening one knee to the side and then breathing into return. And then the same on the other side. So just making sure that you stay nice and still on the roller. Little bony hip points at the front of the pelvis stay really level. And as the one knee opens, the other knee stays pointing up towards the ceiling.
You might even need to just have a quick check and make sure that that one knee isn't sneaking out as the other opens. It might feel like it's staying still, but it might actually be sneaking out. So just have a little check. And if you're already struggling to keep that knee pointing upwards, imagine you get a nice gin and tonic balanced on that knee. You're not allowed to spill any as the other knee opens. So we are working alternate legs, but you can imagine your gin and tonic just hopping back and forth between them. If you want to make it more challenging, we'll just take those hands up towards the ceiling and we'll do the same again. Breathing out to open the knee to one side, breathing in to come back again. If you want a bit of a coordination challenge, as the one knee opens, the opposite arm's going to reach backwards and they both return, and then the other pair. And this is all about maintaining your stability through the body. Stay nice and still on the roller, just moving independently through hip and shoulder joints. Okay, let's go one more on each pair. Come back to centre, let those arms come down. So we're going to go into our single leg stretch, and again, I want you to be really mindful about the position of your lower back and pelvis. If you feel you need to flatten into that roller to make sure you keep the position, that's fine. That is preferable to allowing that pelvis to roll away and the back to arch up. But gold standard is neutral, so you work in whichever manner you feel confident. Okay, so keeping those feet hip width apart, and we're going to keep them in contact with the floor. We're going to breathe out and slide one leg away. Breathe in for that leg to return, and the same with the other one. So really thinking about parallel train tracks for those feet to slide along, hip width apart. And you would like for your leg to stay in that nice neutral alignment. You might feel that your leg wishes to roll in as it straightens. So keep thinking about your kneecaps pointing up towards the ceiling. And again, you might have to have a little peer down the front of the body to notice what's going on.
The bony hip points staying completely level, roller staying nice and still. Each breath out, just drawing the bony hip points towards each other, lengthening the leg away.
breathing in to return. So again, if you want to make that more challenging, hands up towards the ceiling. And exactly the same. You should feel a little bit of opening up through the front of the hip. You might find that you have to work quite hard to maintain your position through lower back and pelvis as that leg slides away, especially if you are a little bit tighter through the front of the hips. Okay, one more each side. And then we'll let those arms come back down to the mat. So this time, we're going to lengthen the leg away, but we're going to keep it just hovered above the floor. So we're just going to straighten that leg out and gently back, and then the other one out and gently back. So this is quite a bit tougher. If you find that that's too much for you, you can just keep the foot on the floor, keep working as you were. Otherwise, just hovering that foot, straightening the leg away. We're going to add in the opposite arm. So as the leg reaches away, opposite arm is going to reach away. Really focus on keeping position through your body, maintaining neutral or keeping the back gently flattening into the roller. What you don't want is your back arching up and away from the roller. And if at any point you're not comfortable, please pause the video, hop off the roller, then have a little roll side to side, and there's a little ball on your back. And then if you want to continue back on the roller, great. Or you could probably do most of this on the floor. It won't be the same balance challenge, but it doesn't matter. Just working at a level that's appropriate for you today. Okay, let's go one more each side. In the middle. Right, we're going to go into our level one scissors. So breathing out, engage with those deep tummy muscles, float one leg up into single tabletop, breathe in for that leg to come back down. Same on the other side. So again, each breath out, just engaging, floating that feather-like leg up, and then breathing in to come back down. Just want to feel that you're creasing at the front of the hip as the leg comes up, opening through the front of the hip as that leg comes down. And we're trying to make sure that our feet come back down to exactly the same spot that they left. You may find that your feet wish to tootle off to the left or to the right. So again, it might be worth just having a little check that we are nice and square. So for you, keeping the arms on the floor might be more than enough of a challenge. If you want to make it harder, you can take those hands up towards the ceiling, and then same again. So if you struggle, usually we struggle with one leg more than the other, just work with the leg that's a bit trickier. Pop the opposite hand on the floor, or the opposite arm on the floor, and just let your weight come into that opposite arm, just to help find a new balance there a little bit. So if that's going well, we could go opposite arm and leg, as the one that leg floats up, opposite arm's going to reach backwards, and then they both return. Keeping it nice and slow, whoops, keeping your focus, keep that idea of each out breath, you just reset through those deeper tummy muscles. Okay, let's go one more each side. So arms come down. We're going to do a little bit of work into double tabletop, and then we'll come off of the roller. So when you're ready, check your position. floating the first leg up, think about those ribs connecting down towards the hips, and then float the second leg up. And from here, we're going to go into level one scissors. So we're going to breathe out, touch your foot down, breathe in to come back up. And the same on the other side. So if you want to make this a little bit easier, just touch your toes down and touch them very close to the end of the roller. If you want to make it a bit harder work, you could touch the whole of the sole of your foot down and touch it down a little bit further away from you. So always making sure those knees come back into that tabletop position. You want to feel like the weight of your thigh can drop down into the back of your hip joint on that leg that's staying still. And I would suggest that probably to be able to maintain your position, you'll need to be flat into the roller now, flat through your back. One more each side. And then we're going to go into our single leg stretch. We're going to breathe out, reach one leg away, breathe in to fold back. Breathe out to reach the other leg away, breathe in to fold back. And the lower you take that leg, the more challenging it will be to your abdominals. Make sure it's your tummy working, not your neck. Check that you've got that nice soft peach between your chin and your chest. Just gently keeping that there. So final progression, if you wish to, we're going to go opposite arm and leg. So always make sure your weight stays into the arm that's on the floor, and we're going to do alternates. So we're going to reach one leg, opposite arm away, and come back. Make sure you've got the weight into the arm on the floor, reach the opposite arm and leg away, and come back. So there will be a slight shift from one side to the other probably, as you just make sure keep that weight into the arm on the floor. But if you're getting super good at this sort of stuff, you might find that you hardly need that arm, whoops, for balance. Whoops. So keep it slow. Let's just go a couple more each side. Come back to the centre, and we'll let one foot come down, let the other foot come down. Very gently roll yourself to one side, and just come onto the floor, grab your head support, draw one knee in, draw the other knee in, and have a little roll side to side. Okay, so we're going to work into bridge next. If you would like to work your hamstrings super hard, we will do bridge with feet on the roller. Otherwise, normal bridge, feet flat on the floor, is a very good option. Okay, so no head cushion. We want to really work those hamstrings. We will have feet on the roller. So whether your feet are on the roller or the floor, you want them hip width apart, nice and parallel, relatively close to your bottom. Length through the back of the neck, as always. Shoulders drawing away from the ears. So when you're ready, you're going to breathe out, sink the ribs down, roll the pelvis towards you, and peel yourself up and away from the mat. Thinking about those knees, trying to reach forward over the toes, keeping the ribs nice and soft, connected. Really squeeze through those bottom muscles. And then when you're ready, breathing out, and peel yourself back down to the mat. So if you have got your feet on the roller, really notice what you can feel through your feet. You want equal weight into each foot. Notice if your big toes do anything strange. Okay, same again. Sinking the ribs, rolling the pelvis towards you, peeling up. Really keep those ribs connected. Make sure it's those glutes working, opening up through the front of the hips. Holding for a breath in, breathing out. Same again, really visualise your backbone right in the centre of your spine. You're peeling up along that central line, holding at the top, and then breathing out to peel back down along that central line. Let's just go for one more. Hold for the breath in at the top, breathing out. Peel back down, and then draw those knees in, have a little roll side to side. bring yourself up to sit, either roll up or roll to one side. Bring yourself up to sit. So we're going to do a little bit of work with the roller across the middle of our back. So you kind of want it just underneath your shoulder blades. So find the base of your shoulder blades and you want your roller just below that. So for us ladies, that's pretty much where your bra comes across the middle of your back. Chaps, you will have to work that out. Okay. So just make sure you are well supported on that roller and it's not going to disappear out from underneath you. Feet hip width apart. Have a little roll of your pelvis towards and away from you a couple of times. So you can probably feel that with that roller underneath kind of mid upper back, it would be quite easy to let the pelvis roll towards you and kind of sink down. So just make sure that you come into a neutral position. So if you make that diamond with your hands again, it's just making sure that your fingers are a bit lower than your thumbs this time. If you can look at my body, we're really looking a relatively straight line, hip to shoulder. If you're sort of sunk down, something like that, and rounded, that's not what we want. And equally, if you're kind of extended up, that's not what we want. So thinking about the natural curve through the back, nicely supported and controlled. I would say for most people, you're going to have to think about your tailbone being a little bit heavy into the floor. If you're not sure, get in touch with me. Okay, so hands behind head. I'm going to interlace my fingers and put my thumbs down the back of my neck. And this is where we really need to focus on the idea of a soft peach between chin and chest, because otherwise it's very easy to move a lot through your neck and not through your upper back. And it's all about mobilising that thoracic upper back area, okay? So we are going to do some abdo prep here. Have a breath in, and as you breathe out, very slowly, allow yourself to extend back over that roller any amount. Have a breath in, and then breathe out. Draw those ribs back down towards the hips and come back up again. So all the way through, we're keeping neutral, we're keeping tummy muscles engaged, little bony hip points drawing towards each other. Breathing out to extend backwards. You may come a long way, you might not come very far at all. It doesn't matter. Keep your soft peach between your chin and your chest. And then breathing out. Send those ribs back down towards the hips. All the time, keeping neutral. And again. Breathing out to extend back slowly. Hold for the breath in. Breathing out to come back up. So if your neck is struggling with this, really focus on your soft peach. Think about supporting your head with your hands. But if it's still not happy, come away from this. Okay, we're just going to go for two more. Last one. And then come back up. So we're going to hold this position with the upper body. We're going to work through the legs. So we're going to start just with a single leg stretch. So breathing out, sliding one leg away, breathing in to come back again, and then the other side. So abdominal is going to be working relatively hard to keep you in position. You shouldn't feel like your neck's having to do too much at all. Keep thinking about that soft peach between chin and chest. Shoulders relaxing down, shoulder blades drawing towards the back pockets. One more each side with a single leg stretch. And then we're going to go to level one scissors. So we're going to breathe out, draw that leg up, breathe in and come back down. So you might feel that actually bringing that knee to that position above your hip is quite difficult to achieve and maintain your neutral position through the lower back and pelvis. So as that knee comes up, you do not want your back to drop. So that might mean you don't bring your knee quite so far. And that's absolutely fine. Really think as the knee floats up about your tailbone, gently pushing down into the mat. Done. Okay. We're going to come into double tabletop. So when you're ready, breathing out, float the first leg up. Get that connection of the ribs towards the hips. Breathe out, float the second leg up. And from here, level two scissors. So breathing out to tap the toes down, breathing in to come back up. So if this is not comfy for you, just come flat on the mat. You can work exactly the same without the roller. Doesn't matter. Breathing out to tap the toes down, breathing in to come back up again. A little bit of a shake of truth going on here. Abs are working really hard. Let's go one more each side, and then we're going to go into single leg stretch. So reaching that leg out. Folding back, out, and folding back. Take that leg a little bit lower if you want, keep the control. Well done, we're nearly there. We're going to go three more each side. Three, keep the heels up. Two. Oh, that's a two actually. You can tell when it gets harder, I struggle to count even more. One more each way. Last one. Well done. Let one foot come down. Let the other foot come down. Gently bring yourself up away from that roller. Hop into one side. Come down into a little ball. And have a good roll side to side. Grab your head cushion so you're comfy. And then we will just finish a little stretch out through the front of those hips. So again, you can do this flat on the mat. You can just keep hold of one knee close to your chest, reach the other leg away, and then point the toes, push the heel away. Or as long as you know you're comfy and happy with this, we're going to peel up into a little bridge, pop the roller well underneath the lower back, draw one knee in and then draw the other knee in. So you need your roller well underneath you so it doesn't go anywhere without you holding onto it. One knee really close into the chest and then just lengthen that other leg away and let gravity sink it down towards the floor. So you may well be much bendier than me. So I would start with a straight leg and let the weight of that straight leg open you up through the front of the hip first. So maybe feel like you're pushing your heel away from you. Make sure you've got this bent knee really tight to the chest. That's keeping your back in a nice safe rounded position. And then once you've had a little bit of time with gravity working on the straight leg, just let the foot sink towards the floor. And you might find that stretch changes just a little. Well done. A couple more breaths here. And then drawing that straight leg back in. Hold on to that knee, nice and close to the chest. Straighten the other leg away. Again, I would push the heel away so you've got the weight working on that really straight leg. Open you up through the front of that hip. Keep the bent knee nice and close to your chest. You may well feel a bit of a stretch into the glutes on that side, and that's great. Reaching the heel away from you on the straight leg. And then let that knee bend and let that foot sink towards the mat. And again, you might feel a slightly different stretch there through the front of that leg. This is quite nice in that gravity really does the work for you. You should be able to relax, release, keep nice, easy, deep breaths. And then when you're ready, draw that knee in. Pop your hands over the front of the roller, take the feet up towards the ceiling. And that should just feel quite nice, just to have your feet higher than your head, slight inversion. Draw those knees back into the chest. Very slowly roll your roller out from underneath you. And let those feet come down. Just have a couple of nice deep breaths there. finish with quite a tough little exercise, so leg pull. So this might not be for all of you. If you've got shoulder problems, that's fine. Leave this one alone. Just have a little stretch and a rest and a finish. So we are going to have the roller underneath the sort of the back of the legs, just above the ankles. Yes, so look really lovely and tall. Fingers facing forwards underneath those shoulders if you can. If you need them turned out or behind you, that is okay, but preferably forwards. So really grow tall. Let that head float up. Lift out of those shoulders. We're going to have a breath in, and as we breathe out, we're going to tuck the tailbone and scoop the bottom forward. So you come up into like a little reverse plank. Hold there for breath in and breathe out. Bottom to come back down again. So be careful as you come up that you're not just pushing your tummy up. Really think about the back of your body working to get that lift. Tummy muscles are engaged as opposed to pushing up towards the ceiling. So when you're ready, breathing out, draw those little bony hip points towards each other, scoop the bottom forwards, really squeeze those bum muscles. Hold at the top there. And breathe out. Come back down. So if you're feeling super strong, we will do a little bit of a more dynamic one for the arms. So, well, it's the whole body really. Great exercise, but it is tough, so see what you think. Breathe in, grow tall. Breathe out, scoot the bottom forwards. Come into a nice straight line. And then breathe out, draw your bottom backwards. Keep pushing into those hands so my bum's still above the floor. And then scoop forwards again. Let's open it backwards and coming forwards. Tough through those arms. Let's just go for one more. Coming back. Coming forwards. And then just gently come back to the floor and have a little fold forwards and just stretch into those hammies. A bit more stretch there with the roller underneath the ankles. If that's not for you, just pop it to one side, it doesn't matter. Just nice deep breaths, relaxing into that stretch. And then gently release. Pop that roller out of the way. We'll just come back down onto the floor. Grab your head cushions and we'll just cross one ankle over the other knee. Keep your toes pulling up towards your shin and push that knee out and away from you. And if you want to, you can draw the second leg in towards your chest. Try and keep your back nice and long on the mat. You want to isolate that stretch into the hip as opposed to curling up into a little ball and just rounding through the back. So if you can't reach around your knee with your head still relaxed on your cushions, then I would keep the foot on the floor, just let your arms relax by your sides. Okay, and then gently release that side and switch over. The other foot over the other knee, draw the toes up towards the shin, knee reaches out and away from you, and then if you want to, you can draw that second leg in towards the chest. And we're looking for a stretch kind of into these muscles here, really. Depending on where you're tight, you might find it more into the inside of your thigh, but really into the muscles, into your bottom and around the outside of the hip. And again, just thinking about the back, staying nice and long on the mat. Just stretching into the muscles around the hip. Okay, and then gently release that side, let both feet come down to the mat. Glue the legs together, take the arms a bit wider. We'll just drop the knees to one side. Hold there for two or three breaths. Nice deep breaths into the top side of the rib cage. Let your head look over the opposite shoulder. on an out breath, gently drawing those knees across, looking over the other shoulder, and again, two or three deep breaths into that top side of the rib cage. And then come back to centre, draw one knee in, draw the other knee in, last little rock side to side, and either roll yourself over onto hands and knees, or we will have a little roll backwards and forwards. And we'll roll all the way up to sit, and we'll just roll forwards over those feet. I'll just shuffle myself back into shot. So all on hands and knees, and then tuck the toes under, roll back over those feet, hands on the mat, hips up towards the ceiling. I'm going to disappear out of shot in a minute, but it doesn't matter. So when you're ready, on a nice out breath, bend the knees, drop the tailbone, and unroll all the way back up to stand. So you stay standing. You can imagine I am also standing, and we'll just have a nice deep breath in and reach up, and then breath out, folding forwards. Two more. Last one. Go. So I hope you enjoyed that. Well done if you did everything in it. That's quite tough, a lot of that. If you didn't, please don't worry though. You know, everyone is at different places, and if you've had shoulder injuries or anything like that, that will have been really difficult, some of that. So I hope you enjoyed it, and hopefully I will see you all soon. Take care. Bye bye.